morning, everybody. How nice it is to see you again. I haven't seen you since Easter time. I wonder if you ate some Easter eggs. I did. Not too many, though, because you don't want to make yourself sick, do you? Anyway, it's good to see you again. And I've changed my shirt again. Can you see that I have a different coloured shirt on? This one's an unusual colour. It's a kind of blue, it's a kind of green. Some people call it aqua, some people call it turquoise. What do you think? What colour do you like to call it? I'm wondering if after story time you might like to go around your house and find some things that are aqua or turquoise. Or maybe you'd like to draw some pictures using that colour. Yeah, pictures of the sky, pictures of the sea, pictures of your clothes, pictures of a rainbow. It's a beautiful colour. Okay, so what's our first song that we always sing at the start of story time? Are you ready? Put your hands up like this. Are you ready? Welcome to the library, the library, the library. Welcome to the library. Hello, hello, hello. Well done. Give yourselves a clap. And what's the next song that we always sing? Can I hear you? I can hear you. You said twinkle, twinkle, little star. Are you ready? Hands up like this. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Give yourselves a clap again for good singing. We didn't talk about what else is in the sky. I think we did talk about it last time, and I think you said moon, and I think you said sun, and I think you said clouds, and you might have said wind. Lots of things up in the sky. When you go outside, you can have a look up and you might even be able to see some shapes in the sky, in the clouds. So the sky's a lovely thing to look up. Lie back, open your eyes and see what you can see. Okay, we're going to do another favourite song to do with fingers. Are you ready? One little, two little, three little fingers. Four little, five little, six little fingers. Seven little, eight little, nine little fingers. 10 little fingers on your hand. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. 10 fingers and 10. What else have you got 10 of? 10 toes. Wiggle your toes. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. 10 fingers and 10 toes. Let's count them again. One little, two little, three little fingers. Four little, five little, six little fingers. Seven little, eight little, nine little fingers. 10 little fingers on my hand. Can you remember another counting song with numbers in it? Can you remember one that starts down like this? And you start low and you start quiet. Are you ready? One potato, two potato, three potato, four, five potato, six potato, seven potato, more. And again. One potato, two potato, three potato, four, five potato, six potato, seven potato, more. And if we're carrying on counting, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. That's right. Eight comes after seven, doesn't it? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Eight. You guys are great counters. Let's see if we can have some songs about some animals. Because I've got some stories about some animals. Big animals, a donkey and a tiger. But before we have those, let's see if we can think of some Australian animals. Can you think of any Australian animals? One that goes hopping? That's right, a kangaroo. And what's that lovely furry one? That lovely soft furry one? It's a koala. They both begin with a letter K. I wonder if any of you guys who go to school know what the letter K looks like. Maybe you can ask somebody afterwards and see if you can practice writing the letter K. Let's sing our cuddly koala song. Are you ready? Cuddly koala. Cuddly koala, possum too, possum too, wallaby and wombat, kangaroo, kangaroo. Now, families, we're going to repeat it. We always repeat songs because it's a fabulous way for the kids to learn. Are you ready? Cuddly koala, cuddly koala, possum too, possum too, wallaby and wombat, wallaby and wombat, kangaroo, kangaroo. Well done, everybody. Oh, we forgot to clap, didn't we? We're clapping once. Can we clap twice? Are you ready? One, two. Let's clap three times. Are you ready? One, two, three. I wonder if any of you are 3 years old. Maybe you're four. Let's clap four times. You ready? One, two, three, and four. And if we were going to clap again, the next number would be five. Well done. You guys are good. Okay. Let's sing our Before the Story song. And it starts off, you're happy and you know it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, nod your head. Nod, nod. If you're happy and you know it, nod your head. Nod, nod. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, nod your head. Now stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. Stamp, stamp. If you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. Stamp, stamp. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, stamp your feet. Now this time, you've got to be really loud. If you're happy and you know it, say we are and say it really loud. Are you ready? If you're happy and you know it, say we are. We are. If you're happy and you know it, say we are. We are. If you're happy and you know it and you really want to show it, if you're happy and you know it, say we are. We are. That was a loud one. Now we're going to do a soft one. Shh. If you want to hear a story, say shh. If you want to hear a story, say shh. If you want to hear a story, if you want to hear a story, if you want to hear a story, say shh. And our two stories today about big animals. And this one is a tiger. What's special about tigers? They have stripes, don't they? And this one is called The Tiptoeing Tiger by Philippa Leathers. She's the author. She's the person who wrote this story called The Tiptoeing Tiger. It's published by Walker Books, and they publish lots of fabulous books. Everyone in the forest knew that tigers were sleek and silent and totally terrifying. When a tiger prowled through the forest, everyone found other places to be. But no one took any notice of little tiger. Roar! No one jumped when he roared. No one ran away when he tumbled through the forest. His brother laughed. Oh, little tiger, you're too small and clumsy to scare anyone. I am not, said little tiger. I'm sleek and silent and totally terrifying. His brother smiled. I don't think you can scare a single animal in the forest, he said. I can, said little tiger. I can, and I'll prove it. So little tiger began to tiptoe through the forest as silently as he could. Tiptoe, 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 roar! You don't scare me, yawned Bat. I could hear you coming a mile away. Oh, bother, said little tiger. And he set off again to find someone else to scare. Tiptoe. Toe, tiptoe, roar! Hello, little tiger, said Elephant. Did I scare you? Asked little tiger. Oh, no, you're much too small. Oh, bother, said little tiger, and he set off again to find someone else to scare. Tiptoe, 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 roar! Was that meant to scare us? Said the monkeys, laughing. Yes, it was, said Little Tiger. But the monkeys just kept on laughing. Little Tiger felt sad. I may not be sleek and silent or totally terrifying, he thought, but I will find someone to scare. Look how sad he looks. Poor Tiger. Just then, a frog jumped splosh into the pond. This is my chance, thought Little Tiger. I can scare that tiny, jumpy frog. And he crept silently up to the water's edge. Tiptoe, 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 roar! Oh, help, cried Little Tiger. Bravely, Little Tiger tiptoed back to the water's edge and slowly peered into the pond. A tiger, as sleek and totally terrifying, peered back. Well, Little Tiger asked his brother, did you scare anyone? As a matter of fact, I did, said Little Tiger. I scared myself, because there he is, looking in the pond and seeing his reflection. That's something else you could do after story time. See if you can see your reflection in a pond outside. I know you can roar, because I've heard you. Okay, my second story is one of my very favourite stories of all time, and it's called The Wonky Donkey by Craig Smith and illustrations by Katz Cowley. And here's a donkey. I might need you to help me with this one. Donkeys say hee-haw, and I'm going to ask you to say hee-haw as well. I was walking down the road and I saw a donkey. And this is where you say hee-haw. Can you say it? Hee-haw. He only had three legs. He was a wonky donkey. I was walking down the road and I saw a donkey. Hee-haw! He only had three legs and one eye. He was a winky wonky donkey. I was walking down the road and I saw a donkey. Hee-haw! He only had three legs, one eye, and he liked to listen to country music. Hee-haw! He was a honky-tonky, winky-wonky donkey. I was walking down the road and I saw a donkey. Hee-haw! He only had three legs, one eye, he liked to listen to country music, and he was quite tall and slim. He was a lanky, honky-tonky, winky-wonky donkey. I was walking down the road and I saw a donkey. Hee-haw! He only had three legs, one eye, he liked to listen to country music, he was quite tall and slim, and he smelt really, really bad. He was a stinky, dinky, lanky, honky, tonky, winky, wonky donkey. I was walking down the road and I saw a donkey. Hee-haw! He only had three legs, one eye, he was quite tall and slim, he smelt really, really bad. And that morning he got up early and he hadn't had any coffee. He was a cranky, stinky, dinky, lanky, honky, donky, winky, honky, donkey. I was walking down the road and I saw a donkey. Hee-haw! He only had three legs, one eye. He liked to listen to country music. He was quite tall and slim. He smelt really, really bad. He got up that morning early and hadn't had any coffee. And he was always getting up to mischief. He was a hanky-panky, cranky, stinky, kinky, lanky, honky-tonky, winky-donky, donkey. I was walking down the road and I saw a donkey. Hee-haw! He only had three legs, one eye. He liked to listen to country music. He was quite tall and slim. He smelt really, really bad. That morning he got up early and he hadn't any coffee. He was always getting up to mischief, but he was quite good looking. He was a spunky, hanky-panky, cranky, stinky-dinky, henny-ky, hank-honk-tonk, winky-honky, donkey. I was walking down the road and I saw a donkey. Hee-haw! So, there's our donkey story. That's a favourite, isn't it? We've got a very easy craft for you to make today. Remember, families, craft is really good for their fine motor skills. How to use scissors, how to use glue, how to use their imagination as well. So you need a large round circle and a small round circle and some eyes, and you can make a sort of donkey. Okay? And if you make a donkey and you'd like to send us one, you can send it to hstaff@harvey.wa.gov.au. That's our email address. We'd love to see some of the work that you do. Okay, and before we finish today, let's do our washing our hands song one more time. Are you ready? Wash your hands like this, wash your hands like this, first the front and then the back between your fingers too. That's it for today, everyone. Bye.